Hi friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the formation of a covalent bond, that is how a formation of covalent bond takes place, as well as we have also did the inadequacies of octet. But in that case we have discussed that there are also certain kind of covalent molecules, they are basically polar in nature. So what is the reason behind that is a covalent bond can be polar in nature? Let us talk about this in this lecture. So initially we have discussed about that is how a covalent bond forms between the two atoms which has not too much of electronegativity difference. For example, if I'm talking about the formation of bond between chlorine and fluorine, formation of bond between hydrogen and hydrogen, or formation of bond between any kind of molecule, for example, if I would say like nitrogen and nitrogen. So in this case, because as we could observe that both the atoms are the same, and that is the reason that obviously if we are talking about chlorine and that of the another chlorine, they will have same electronegativity, and that's the reason the difference between the electronegativity in this case would be zero. Similarly, that in case of that is in hydrogen molecule, or in case of oxygen also, if you would observe, then this nitrogen and this nitrogen, the both are electronegative, and that's the reason the tendency to acquire the electrons to itself, the both will have the same tendency, and that's the reason the difference between the electronegativity in all the cases will be zero. And that leads to formation of covalent bond. Even that is the main thing, because the electrons would be shared with each other, and all the bonding pair would be shared by each other, and that's the reason that it will follow the complete octet rule, or we could say that the bond formation, it would be very much strong, and like that of we could say it as covalent bond. But also there are certain molecules, they exhibit the formation of a covalent bond either by sharing a shared pair of electrons, and that's the reason that we say that they are forming covalent bond. But it is not necessary that the both will have the same electronegativity. They can have the difference in their electronegativities, and that is the reason we are talking that a covalent bond also can exhibit a property known as polarity, or basically known as the polar nature or polar character of the covalent bond can be observed in this case. So let me talk about this one, because this all molecules that as you could see over here, these are basically known as non-polar. Non-polar as it itself indicates, because what does polar means? Polar means the one where we could find the difference between the positive charge and the negative charge, and that is how we could say south pole and north pole. They both are of opposite charges when it comes to magnetism also. But when it is non-polar, means there is no difference between the positive or negative. We could say that both are the same. So therefore, even this two will have the same electronegativity. So therefore, there is no electronegativity difference. None. We can't say that this one is positive or this one is negative, because they both are the same. Neither we can say it for the hydrogen molecule. But what if we are talking about molecules like HCl, NHF. Talking about this is not an ionic compound. The reason behind that is because hydrogen is the one which has particular, we could see in this manner, that is the shared pair of electrons are the reason behind this. We could say that the bond happens. So with this, we did this concept earlier also. Let me give a glimpse of this one. Suppose if I'm talking about hydrogen, so hydrogen consists of one electron in its outermost shell, but it needs one electron more so as to give a complete electronic configuration like that of helium. So obviously it will try to acquire electrons toward itself also so as to maintain the stable electronic configuration. But we are talking about the chlorine. Chlorine has an outermost shell which consists of 7 electrons. Obviously even the chlorine atom needs one electron so as to get a stable electronic configuration just like that of a noble gas. So obviously in this case, this electrons will be shared by both of them, that is hydrogen and that of fluorine, and that is the reason that sharing of electrons result in the formation of covalent bond. So similarly, we are talking about HF also. But covalent bond is basically its sharing of the electrons so as to form a bond. But in actual practice, we know that chlorine is more electronegative compared to that of the hydrogen, and even fluorine is more electronegative compared to that of the hydrogen. So in this case, we could observe that the chlorine will have the tendency to acquire the electrons of the other atom towards itself during a formation of covalent bond. So similarly, fluorine is also more electronegative. Again, it will have a tendency to acquire electron of the hydrogen towards itself whenever it is forming a covalent bond. So now we could see that the density is been changing. How? Let me give an example in this case. just a short example. If I'm talking about A and B, suppose if the both are having the same electronegativity, so obviously we could see that the electrons are being shared equally. So if I observe, then this electron, that is I have written over here, that will be shared equally by A and B, and that's the reason that this kind of molecule will be known as non-polar. Simple. And talking about the density or the charge density around it, it will be the same. So if I'm talking about it in this way, so this is the charge density that has been, and in between A and B are being located. So the charge is basically uniformly distributed in this case, and that's the reason we cannot see the distortion of such charges, and it has been uniformly distributed on A also as well as on B also. So this is the kind of thing that is observed in non-polar molecules, and that's the reason we can't say that one is positive charge and one is negative charge. But meanwhile, if I'm talking about this way, like suppose A and B, they are forming covalent bond. But suppose in this case B is the one which is forming which is having a more electronegativity. So this actually shows the actually density or the difference between these two. That is, this line actually it shows the balance of the electrons on both the side. But if B is more electronegative, obviously it will try to acquire its shared electrons towards itself. So this is how we could see the electrons would be shared on the B side. So now when it comes to the charge density, it will not be similar to that of the earlier one that we have talked about. So because in this case the B is more electronegative, so it will try to acquire the shared electrons toward itself, and that is how we could see that there would be distortion of the charge density, and the structure would be, or we could say the charge density would be in this manner, where B is more electronegative, so therefore we could see that the charge density will be more on, that is, the B one. So in this case, because the charge is basically present more on the B atom, so therefore there would be, obviously we could see or we could observe there would be difference between those two, and the partial negative charge and partial positive charge that would generate. So now because B has more charge density, so therefore it will have partial negative charge, while A will have partially positive charge. So this will give a rise to the polarity, or we could see that polarization is what we could see over here, and that is how this AB is now called as polar molecule. So similarly here also, if you are talking about, so chlorine is more electronegative while that of compared to that of hydrogen, so therefore we could say that the chlorine will be having a partially negative charge, and hydrogen will be the one that is having partially positive charge. Meanwhile, talking about the fluorine also, fluorine will also be a partially negative charge, while talking about hydrogen, it will be partially positive charge. So basically, this polarity of the covalent bond is basically denoted with the help of a unit, and that is basically known as mu. So this is what it is represented with. So what is mu actually? Mu is known as the dipole moment. And what is dipole moment? Dipole moment is a property where we could say that a particular covalent bond is, or whether a covalent molecule. So what is mu? Mu actually is basically a measurement of giving the polar nature of a covalent bond, and it is basically denoted by mu. And what is it actually? It is the product of, that is, the charge we represented by Q and R. So what is Q into R? So talking about Q, Q is basically the magnitude of the charges, and that could be positive or negative also, so it represents the magnitude. While talking about the R is the distance between that is the positive charged and the negative charge. That is what we have got, because this is positive and this is negative, so that is the difference between the distance between these two, and this is how we could say that the mu is, and it is the product of it. And talking about the next one, that is this mu, obviously, which is known as a dipole moment, or I would write it over here also, dipole moment. So the dipole moment is basically the property of dipole moment is basically the measurement of the that is polarity of a covalent bond. So even it will have a particular unit. So that is what the unit of mu is, basically d by. It is denoted by d by, and what is d by? I will represent it over here. So it has been noted that 1 d by it is mentioned with D or symbol D. So 1 divided by A is equals to basically 3.33 into 10 raised to minus 30 coulomb meter. The reason behind coulomb and meter is because we know that is mu has a unit of, that is mu has a formula of Q to R, and Q has a unit of coulomb, and talking about R is the distance between these two, and that is basically denoted by meter, and this is what the D by has a unit of. So now let us talk about this one, that is talk about HCl and HF. So it has been noted that this is the mu value of the HCl, it has been found to be that of 1.03 D, and talking about the HF, it has been found to be that is 1.91 D. So this indicates that so this is the value that we have got for that is for HCl and for that is HF. But usually we denote when we have to showcase the polarity of a particular covalent bond, we usually show with this kind of arrow that I am going to represent over here, and that is what I am going to represent, because the electronegativities or the tendency of the attraction of the electron is more towards the one which has more electronegativity. So now this is the arrow that I am representing, and this is what indicating that the electron are moving towards the electronegative, more electronegative atom, and here also the electrons are been moving toward, or the density of the electrons are moving from the to the more electronegative atom, and this is the symbol. But while talking about this one, that is this two value, we have got to know that is the dipole moment of HF is found to be that is 1.91 dy. So this indicates that the HF is much more polar than that of the HCl, and this is how it also indicates the polarity nature or polar nature of a covalent bond. So similarly, we could also represent it for H2. So we actually know that H2 doesn't have a linear structure. Actually, it has a structure that is what I am going to represent over here, and that is basically a triangular planar. So this is what I am representing it. So because of the oxygen, which is more electronegative, obviously we could write the symbol in this way here also. So the both the electrons have been moving towards the that of oxygen, but talking about what would the resultant dipole. So the resultant dipole can be represented in this way, where we could see it is moving away from, means that is the resultant dipole. So it depends on what we are taking, and so therefore, even though the water, it has this much of structure, even though we can't say that it is a non-polar molecule, because we can see that the resultant value, that is mu, is not equals to zero. But we are talking about the carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide has a linear structure, and even though if we are drawing this structure in this way or representing it, here we can't find any kind of difference. So there is no resultant dipole moment, and that's the reason that the mu of this one would be zero. That is the reason that H2O is basically a polar molecule. But talking about carbon dioxide, it is basically non-polar. So in this case, this one is the one that is showing a covalent bond, but still it is polar. So that's the reason the bonds are basically known as polar covalent bonds. And this is it that I wanted to explain. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have shared this video with the friends. And don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.